The ingredients you're going to need are 2 and 1/4 cups of all-purpose flour, 3 tablespoons of sugar. Okay, to get a bowl of a stand mixer, or if you want to use a handheld mixer, get a big bowl.
Robin.
Shut.
A mixer, or a big bowl if you're using a handheld mixer. Put your 2 1/4 cups of flour. Still not ready. 3 tablespoons of sugar.
1 each? How many?
1 1/2 teaspoons of yeast, instant or rapid rise. 3/4 of a teaspoon salt. Get your four tablespoons of butter and cut it into a couple pieces and put it in a bowl, not touching. Make sure you wash your hands. Then
microwave
until it softens. Not, you know, the butter is softened when you can push into it lightly and it makes an indent. Now with your flour, sugar, yeast, and salt, before you turn on your stand mixer, add your 1/2 cup of room temperature water, butter, and egg. Start your mixer on low speed and stir. And take it off. Then take your dough and knead it for a bit. Keep the flour on your hands and your table so that the dough doesn't stick to you.
What do you see? You have dough.
Now to make the dough into a ball, press your palm into the dough, then fold it in half, and do it until your dough looks smooth. Now, to make it into a ball, use your hands to make small circles in the dough. inside of a bowl and put oil in a small bowl and put your dough in it. Then plastic wrap. Then put your dough in the fridge for 1 to 1.5 hours until the dough rises. After you let the dough sit for 1 hour to 1.5 hours, get a 9-inch metal cake pan, line it with parchment paper, and spray some oil. In a small bowl, put 3/4 cup of brown sugar, light brown sugar for frosting. In 1 1/4 teaspoon of ground cinnamon and a pinch of salt. Then take a fork and mix it all together. Next, melt 2 tablespoons of unsalted butter in a small microwave-safe bowl. This time, make sure it's melted, not just softened. When the butter's done melting, it should look like this. Get your dough out onto the counter and flatten it to about a 16 by 8 inch rectangle. It should be about 1/2 inch thick. Once the dough looks kind of like this, take a pastry brush and coat it with butter and spread it on the dough. Leave a 1-inch gap at the top without butter. Make sure you evenly coat the whole thing. Now I've put all the butter, and I'm going to take my cinnamon sugar. Now that you've put your butter, take your cinnamon sugar and sprinkle it onto your dough. After you do that, take a bench scraper and cut your dough into strips. Traditionally, you're supposed to roll the whole thing, but it's easier to cut it into strips first. After you're done cutting, you need to roll your cinnamon rolls. Like that.
Okay.
When you're done rolling them, when you're done rolling them, make sure you put them in the pan spread apart a little bit. Oh, really? Then you could have all the last one. then scrape up any leftover cinnamon sugar and sprinkle it over the top of them. The last one, put in the middle. Then cover it with plastic loosely and let it sit for 30 to 45 minutes in room temperature. After the rolls have sat for 30 to 35 minutes, take off the plastic cover and preheat your oven to 325 degrees, and then put the cinnamon rolls.
Put up with how many?
For about 45 minutes, or until the cinnamon rolls are golden brown in color. Next, get half a cup of powdered or confectioner's sugar, and 2 tablespoons of whole milk.
That's not whole milk.
Or any milk, but this is whole milk.
No, it isn't.
Stockbridge, how many?
Now mix together half a cup of powdered sugar and 2 tablespoons of milk.
That's the glaze, right?
Yep. You'll know the glaze should be very watery. And you should be able to drizzle it onto the cinnamon rolls with a spoon. The cinnamon rolls are now done. We just took them out of the oven. Now I think we're going to let them cool for maybe 5-10 minutes. And then we're going to put the glaze on them. Now we're transferring the cinnamon rolls from the pan to a plate to glaze them. I'm using tongs because they're kind of sticky. Okay. Is it coming? Okay guys, now I'm gonna let them cool for a few more minutes and then glaze them. Okay. Now that they're cool, I'm going to put the glaze on them.